These days, if you walk into a restaurant in Beijing during the lunchtime rush hours, it's highly likely that no waiter would show up to take your order. Instead, in many restaurants, a server at the door greets customers and reminds them to use what are called unmanned services. In other words, automated services which don't require a human waiter. This new type of restaurant has gained varying degrees of adoption in China. Almost every restaurant supports mobile payment, and a vast majority of them also allow customers to order online without having to refer to a physical menu. Some restaurants in the US are also experimenting with unmanned services, particularly in airports, but the concept hasn't yet reached the same level of popularity as it has in China. Unmanned restaurant services work in three steps: ordering, paying, and receiving the order. The first step is to order food through an app or website. Once seated at a table, customers scan a QR code with their phones to access the restaurant site or app. On their phones, customers can browse the menu, select items, and add special requests for their order. For example, how spicy they want a specific dish to be. After confirming all these choices, they can place the order online. Next, customers make payments via the same mobile app or site. After confirming the order, customers are taken to a payment screen to pay in advance before receiving their food. The final step is to receive the meal. Some unmanned restaurants use automated delivery trucks or robots to serve meals. Customers receive a push notification when the automatic delivery begins. After that, customers are ready to claim their meal by picking it up off the delivery truck or server robot. However, some restaurants rely on waiters instead of robots to serve meals. So, what are the benefits and drawbacks of unmanned restaurants services? Unmanned restaurants are convenient and efficient, which benefits both customers and restaurants. Especially during the busiest times, unmanned services make it possible for customers to help themselves, reducing wait times. In addition, unmanned services require little to no social interaction, which means a customer can have the entire meal without talking to a waiter. That may be a downside to some social people, but other customers appreciate it a lot. In terms of drawbacks, insufficient customization is a major pain point. Many unmanned systems don't support personal requirements like less sugar or salt. Other systems do allow for customization, but those options are very hard to find and require staff to guide users to find them. Secondly, people often dine with other people, but in many unmanned restaurants, there is only one QR code for a table, corresponding to the order for the whole table. That means a group of people dining together need to designate one person to scan the code and then pass the person's phone around. As you can imagine, this is inefficient and annoying to customers. Lastly, many unmanned services still have systematic gaps. The ordering systems usually do not synchronize the dishes on the menu with the available ingredients in the kitchen. Ordering an item out of stock wastes both customer and staff's time, since the latter must interact with the customer to help them recover from the issue. So what can we learn from the unmanned restaurant services? The number one takeaway is to always consider the context in which users will use the system. This case study reminds us how important field studies, task analysis, and discovery research are whenever we employ a new technology. In addition, service design is crucial. Problems like the digital menu failing to sync with in-stock ingredients can be very frustrating. We need to use service design thinking to address these inconsistencies and optimize efficiency.